Welcome all to yet another video, Dr. RS and you, on the science of cosmetics and personal care products. Today we are in part 78. We will talk about hair setting sprays and gels. Hair setting derived through polymers, which add stiffness to the individual hair and create temporary bonds between the hair shafts to maintain the hair in a desired position. So, compared to the chemical methods of hair straightening and hair perming, this is more a physical phenomena. The hair is maintained in the desired position using polymers, right? So there are two types of products generally. Hair sprays is an aerosolized or pump spray liquid applied to the hair following styling to maintain the hair in a desired position. Hair gels are similar to hair sprays, except that they are squeezed from the tube rather than sprayed from the bottle. This product is applied to towel dried damp hair and distributed on the hair shafts by hand combing to form a thin film. If a small amount of gel is applied, the hair will have a natural look and feel. If a large amount of gel is applied, the hair will have wet, spiky look and a stiff feel. Hair gels are available in two types: styling gels and sculpturing gels. Styling gels offer moderate hold, while sculpturing gels offer strong hold. This is particularly important for persons with thinning hair that can make the hair look thicker. Right? Basically, the hair sprays and gels are used to set the hair and in the way you want. Right? Now, the most important ingredient in hair sprays and hair gels is the polymer that makes the hair set. Polymers like PVP in the product add stiffness to the individual hairs and create temporary bonds between the hair shafts. This means that hairspray film or hair gel film can become sticky when mixed with perspiration, humidity and other in the biological or external conditions. And therefore, the property of the polymer film can change. There were constant innovation in the field of hair setting polymers. In order to make high hold hairsprays or hair gels, the PVP, polyvinyl pyrrolidone, a common polymer that was used, PVP, was mixed with vinyl acetate to form a new polymer, PVPVA, while vinyl acetate made the hairspray more resistant to water in the environment. It also made the hairspray harder to remove with shampooing. Even shampooing, it was difficult to remove the polymer because it formed such a good film that it kept the hair set for a longer time. This led to the development of other copolymer resins of vinyl methyl ether and malic acid hemiesters, PVP, MA, and copolymer resins of vinyl acetate and rotenic acid or dimethyl hydantoin formaldehyde. So lot of polymers were investigated. Flexible hold hairsprays that provide high hold with reduced stiffness may contain methacrylate copolymers also, such as polyvinyl pyrrolidone, dimethyl aminoethyl methacrylate. Right? So there were a lot of innovations in the field of polymers for hair setting, that the hair setting was flexible, easily removable, at the same time very resistant to the external humidity. Its property doesn't change to the external humidity or because of the sweat. So when you see the key ingredients that go into hair setting products, the most important ingredient is the copolymer. It's the key ingredients, polyvinyl pyrrolidone and vinyl acetate, vinyl methyl ether and malic acid, hemi esters, polyvinyl pyrrolidone and dimethyl aminoethylene methacrylate, all those polymers which we saw, no? A lot of innovations has happened in this area. Then plasticizer like mineral oil, linoleum, castor oil, butyl palmitate. What is this plasticizer? Plasticizer is one which makes the polymer, copolymer, flexible, right? It should not crack, break. So it has to be flexible. So plasticizer is one which makes the copolymers that has been deposited on the hair more flexible, right? Humectant, sorbitol and glycerol, that maintains the moisture balance. Solvent, SD alcohol. SD alcohol 40 is a denatured ethyl alcohol. Denatured ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. These are the most commonly used solvents. Then conditioners, panthenol, plant proteins, hydrolyzed animal protein and quaternary polymers. Okay, the formulation can be water based or water alcohol based. It's called hydroalcoholic based. Okay, the alcohol used, denatured ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. These are the alcohols used in the preparation. Right, now we will see some of the copolymers available in the market. Very few examples. There are lot of choices of copolymers. We will see some of the examples, very few examples of the copolymers available in the market. Right, so acrylate C12 succinate hydroxyacrylate copolymer, Acudin LT20 is a hair fixative polymer, excellent choice for extreme hair styling product such as hair gels, styling aids and sprays, because it offers stiff hold with maximum humidity resistant and does not flake, right? So same way, the other Acudin 1000 polymer achieve long lasting control, resistant to flaking. Then PVP Lubiscal, just a PVP 20% solution. Then octyl acryl amide acrylate butyl aminoethyl methacrylate copolymer, no? It's a polymer, it's a hard holding amphoteric acrylic hair fixed polymer. Developed primarily for alcoholic or hydroalcoholic hair spray formula specifically. Their composition is inherently stiff and moisture resistant. Right. Butyl ester of PVMMA. PVMMA is copolymer is a copolymer of methyl vinyl ether, malic anhydride and malic acid. PVAMA with butyl ester of PVM, MA, right? So, hydrolyzed corn in a very natural, non-synthetic hair-setting polymers, they have tried hydrolyzed corn also. Right? Polymer is a bio-derivative hair fixative polymer for exceptional humidity resistant, excellent durability and frizz control. Right? Same way VP, VA copolymer is another hair-setting polymer and styling agent. So, there are lot of choices in the market. I've just shown some of the examples. One example from very things, no, one starch, one PVP, one acrylate polymer. So, some examples of the hair setting polymers. Right. So, what we will do is we will see two formula in the market. It's a marketed product. So, this is a hair setting gel. Right. It contains water, VP, dimethyl amino methacrylate copolymer. This is the copolymer. PPG 50 Citrus 20. It's an emulsifier. Triisopropanol amine. It is a neutralizer. See, the polymer should be neutralized. This is the neutralizer. Oleate 20. It's the emulsifier. Then carbamer, it's the rheology modifier. Again, it has polyvinyl pyrrolidone also. This carbamer also can help in setting. This trisodium isopropanolamine is required to neutralize carbamer and the DMDM hydantoin preservative, sorbitol humectant, propylene glycol humectant, then fragrance PG12 dimethicone. Okay, it's the emollient and also it can act as a plasticizer, right? Olealconium chloride, this is a cationic conditioning agent, tetrasodium EDTA chelating agent, panthenol vitamin conditioner, gelatin, keratin, amino acid, lysine, hydroxy, lysine, hydroxypropyl trimonium chloride. It's also a cationic conditioner and color. Basically, this is a gel where oleates 20, PPG citrus 20 can be a solubilizer, right? It's a solubilizer. The clear gel solubilizer, right? Then the polymers. Polymer is VP, dimethyl amino ethyl methacrylate copolymer, right? This is the hair setting polymer. With this has cationic conditioners, then it has panthenol, right? So this is a combination of ingredients where it sets the hair, it conditions the hair. Right? So, this is the hair setting gel, a typical hair setting gel example. Right? A simple hair setting spray example is alcohol, no, denatured alcohol, water, acrylates, hydroxy ester acrylate copolymer. This is the hair fixing polymer, fragrance, amino methyl propanol. So amino methyl propanol used to adjust the pH. Cyclopentasiloxane, it's a cyclomethicone. So the spray spreads well and the cyclomethicone evaporates, right? Propylene glycol humectant, color, right? So this is the hair setting spray. Right, the solvent is SD alcohol and the polymer is acrylate hydroxy ester acrylate copolymer. This is the polymer, copolymer, which is used for hair setting. Right, this is much more simpler formula and the gel formula which we saw, it has other ingredients also, benefit ingredients, which apart from hair setting spray, the conditioning benefits also with cationics, it's provided through the hair gel, right? This is what I would like to share you with this topic, the hair setting topic, hair setting spray and gels. Thank you for listening to me in this topic. Till we connect in the next part. Thank you for listening. Bye to you all. Keep smiling. Be safe. Be happy.